Reading scholarly materials is an inevitable part of your academic experience. Learning how to effectively and efficiently read scholarly materials will help you better understand your subject matter and help you get more from your sources. This video will discuss how to identify, understand, and effectively read scholarly materials. Scholarly materials can go by many different names, such as research, academic works, or the literature. So what are we talking about when we talk about scholarly materials? Typically, scholarly materials refer to the research and creative output of experts in a particular subject area. This could be anything from books, peer-reviewed journal articles and conference proceedings, to performances and works of visual art. When your professor asks you to use scholarly materials, they are generally referring to sources found through your academic library. The first step to reading and understanding scholarly materials is identifying them. In general, scholarly materials can be long and difficult to comprehend. Because they are written by experts, they use jargon or specialized language from the field, and you often need to have some background knowledge to fully understand the concepts. Let's discuss a few more ways that you can identify scholarly materials. One easy way to identify scholarly materials is by their appearance. Scholarly materials, specifically scholarly journal articles, look a particular way. They tend to be long and very text-heavy. This means that they will feature few decorative images and no advertisements. Instead, they often display data through diagrams, charts, tables, or graphs. Scholarly articles are also typically divided into labeled sections. Audience is another way to identify scholarly materials. By audience, we mean the intended readers of the article. Think about the purpose of the article and who might benefit from reading it. The audience for most scholarly materials is other scholars and experts in their fields, but can also include professionals or students. Finally, you can identify scholarly materials by looking at the content of the work. Scholarly articles go through a process called peer review, in which other researchers in the field review the content of the article before it gets published. This means that scholarly articles are structured the same way, outlining the research process that the authors took to reach their conclusions. This includes using discipline-specific jargon and formatting the writing into specific sections. Let's take a look at those sections more in depth. Because you will be encountering many scholarly articles during your time in college, it is important for you to know and understand the purpose of each element. Let's take a minute to dissect the anatomy of a scholarly research article. On the first page, you'll have the basic information of the article, including the title, authors, and publication information. Then there's an abstract, which is a brief overview of the article. The introduction introduces the reader to the topic and states the purpose and importance of the research. This is where you will find the author's research questions or hypothesis. Next is the literature review, which puts the current research into context by discussing past research on the topic. Following that is the methods section, which clearly outlines each step of how the research was conducted. Enough detail is provided in this section so that other researchers can duplicate the study. After the methods is the results. This section objectively outlines what was found in the study. This is generally where the researchers will indicate whether they accept or reject their hypothesis. Lastly, is the part of the article where the authors discuss what their research means in a more global way. In the discussion and conclusion sections, authors will explain and interpret their findings and discuss what implications their research may have. A list of sources referenced in the research are listed in the bibliography at the end of the article. So now that you know all the components of scholarly materials, let's talk about a strategy for effectively and efficiently reading them. Start with the title and abstract to determine if the article is relevant to your topic. Then, read the introduction to get an understanding of why the research is being conducted. Skip all the way to the end to read the discussion and conclusion sections to find out what the researchers can conclude from their findings. This is where you'll find the information that you cite in your writing. After that, take a brief look at the literature review to understand the research in a larger context. Then review the methods to get an understanding of how the research was conducted. Skim the bibliography to get an idea of the sources the authors used. Lastly, skim through the results section to get an understanding of the details of the findings. And that's it. Be sure to go back and reread anything that is unclear and to determine what you might reference in your own paper. In this video, we've discussed how to identify, understand, and efficiently read scholarly materials. As always, if you have any questions or need any help, feel free to contact your subject librarian. Good luck!